We had part two of the Music City Miracle, a Hail Mary, and a 4th-and-1 stop in overtime for the win. Just an absolutely wild Lions-Titans game. And Eric, those final 3 minutes of regulation, I mean, can you remember another crazier set of 3 minutes in an NFL game?
Pretty wild. We had a little bit of everything, like you said, a little controversy, some excitement there in the middle. And you know, Jake Locker, I think, was probably lost a little bit in this game, was how well he played. You know, career high in yards passing, I think that was important. Without CJ2K really doing much of anything, 29 yards combined on 14 touches, the fact that Locker was able to step up and give his team a 2-touchdown lead late in the game was terrific. But the way the Lions came back did show some life there. You know, 2 touchdowns with Sean Hill, a backup quarterback, an amazing performance there. The Hail Mary at the end, reminiscent of the Mike Thomas play a couple years ago. And then we headed to overtime where the real excitement happened.
You know, with the new overtime rules, the Titans go in, they go ahead and go for the field goal. And then the Lions get the ball back and they decide to not go for the field goal. Jim Schwartz says to go for it, though he said he was going to call. They were trying to draw offsides. Botched snap, botched play. What do you think about that play?
It looked like the only guy who wasn't on the right page was Dominic Raiola, 15-year center. I mean, a guy who's been in the league forever. I mean, somebody who should understand what's going on. Schwartz, as you said, called it a miscommunication. But the Lions have had a lot of these things. You know, they're a penalty-prone team. They've made a lot of mistakes. 2 key defensive penalties on the drive there in overtime that allowed the Titans to get that field goal. So, some poor coaching. They're now 6-9 if you count the postseason in the last 15 games. It's a team that sort of lost its way. And as we've seen with some of these crazy games and big plays like this, one team can kind of gain something. Maybe the Titans get galvanized while the Lions perhaps head downward a little bit and they face a Minnesota team coming off a big upset. Who knows what the future holds for this team?
You mentioned Chris Johnson, another nothing game, but yep. Jake Locker puts up some big performances. How can we forget the Nate Washington catch? Just another crazy play in this game. So we'll see. The Titans look pretty bad in the first 2 weeks, look pretty good in week 3. We'll see where these two teams go from here. To read more of Eric's analysis from that game and the rest of week 3, be sure to check out his Shorts and Shells column at our website, profootballweekly.com.